Hello. I'm George Romero. I'm here to tell you a Deadtime story. Now I lay me down to rest, but there's a goblin upon my chest. He's gray and ugly and very gory, and he wants to tell me a Deadtime story. I see you have your popcorn ready, so
fasten your seatbelts. Are you sure you checked all the windows and doors? Don't be afraid. Be very afraid.
I love you, you know.
Yeah, you better prove it, mister. Yeah. I should put this on my chain.
You scared?
As long as you're with me. Gorgeous.
30-foot ceilings through here. 60-foot we can get further down after we get through the Tunnel of Love.
Okay, I'll bite. What's the Tunnel of Love?
You really want to know?
I don't think so.
Hey, is that writing up there?
I don't think anybody climbed all the way up there to write you a note, Garrett.
Not unless they had something really important to say.
Maybe they were just very tall, long bodies. Very long, hard bodies.
You are terrible.
Nice to see you, C. Morales.
Shh.
Evening bat. Don't worry, they hibernate till the bugs come out.
It's a beautiful specimen of batness.
I'm stuck.
How can you be stuck when you're behind us?
No more late night pizza for you. No more beer.
Fuck you, Craig.
I mean, no more fucking me if you two are getting married. I wouldn't hear of it.
How'd you guys get through here?
You gotta eat healthy and exercise to keep up with me and Donna. Ain't that right, Donna?
Just keep crawling.
You like the view?
You're incorrigible.
You know, I'm gonna look that up with you guys.
You guys both had grits for breakfast.
What the hell?
And okra.
Stop, you're making me hungry.
You guys are both sick, twisted fucking people. Whoa, whoa!
Don't worry, it won't hurt you.
Yeah, it'll just eat your eyes out.
Don't wimp.
You're a spelunker now.
A caver, not a spelunker.
What's the difference?
Oh. A spelunker's untrained, inexperienced.
A wimp?
Stop it, you are not a wimp. I would not be in love with a wimp.
Hey, a caver has gone down, gone under. He's tasted this down below.
Does everything have to have a sexual connotation with you, Craig?
What's he talking about?
Those who can, do. Those who can't, take their friends on little field trips.
Oh, I can, baby. Don't even worry about that.
I don't do when you're alone, stroker.
Damn to the heart.
What, you gotta pee?
Shut up.
Gary! Donna!
Gary!
Rock. Donna, he's hurt. Help me with this rock.
Okay,
come on.
Okay.
It's gonna be okay, Gary. We got you, man. It's gonna be okay, buddy.
I'm bad.
Just help me. I'm gonna count three. Come on. One, two.
Ah!
Yeshua. Yeshua. Cut this off. Get Yeshua. Garrett, it's going to be okay, man. Don't worry.
We didn't tell anyone where we were going.
No.
Here. Hey, here. Eat this.
Thank you. It's gangrene. You know what that means?
Yeah.
I mean, you know we have to.
Yeah.
Just took an extra few inches. Still the same time.
What day?
I don't know.
I can't.
If you don't, we're all going to die. We'll do it quick. Just an extra few inches. If anybody ever finds us, we saved his life. He has to know the rest.
We'll know, won't we?
You have to do it. I have to hold it down. Extra few inches.
I can't.
If you don't, we're all going to die.
Gonna die.
You're not.
Can't stay with me, Donna. Gotta get out.
You can't get out.
I can help.
can't. Too weak.
Then you can come back. Help me. We could be together.
Weeks after their disappearance, a third caver, Gary Nardini, has been missing since the rock slide that started the incident by closing off the lower section of the cave. Nardini is a business administration student at a local university. The trio were the subject of a massive search, which started when their SUV was found on the edge of Wickhaven Gorge last month. Fire Chief Nick Bell of Farmington said that most hikers who have been lost in the caves have been found in a relatively short period of time. Ordeal sometime soon. Meanwhile, Metzger and Jacob Yansky are in stable condition and recovering at Uniontown Hospital.
Dr. Weber to the ER. Dr. Weber to the ER.
I'm sorry.
They're still looking for him.
I won't find him.
Going home tomorrow. My parents got me some clothes, and Dr. Owen says you'll be out next week. I think we have to stick to our story.
Thank you.
It's a good thing Donna and Gary never got married.
Now that was a grim fairy tale.
It's not like they could kiss and make up. Are you paying attention? You could be next.
Now I'm hungry. Are you hungry? What do you say we go out for a bite?
If you're done screaming, we have another story.
Remember, I'll be late tonight.
Again?
This year the doctorate, I'm day tenure, and...
Tomorrow the world. Yeah, right.
Kids!
Can't you calm them down before you leave? Take them with you.
Bye, kids. About a run later, Dickie boy.
Can't have them all tied up.
You're just afraid I'll kick your butt.
Language. Not till after lunch.
Professor, it's Matt Lilly from class. I was sick Friday. I saw her terrace and she told me that I should just stay in bed all day.
On Friday, we discussed Nazi Germany as it relates to Gibbon's decline and fall of the Roman Empire. And we learned that Commodus was not the insatiable barbarian some historians claim he was. Why? Matt.
I was sick. I left you a message.
So then I'm sure you spent the weekend in bed reading that Commodus was weak, impressionable, that he succumbed to pressures and passions and pleasures of the flesh. Who pressured him, Matt?
I don't know.
You missed my class.
I saw Nurse Harrison.
The tide of history does not tarry for understanding. Who said that?
I don't know.
And you probably never will. Good day, Mr. Lilly. I said good day. There will be no drops or withdrawals from my classes. Have an incomplete request form on my desk by 3:00. Never miss my class.
A bit less enthusiastic than usual, but
sorry. I was late.
What?
I got one of those kits at the drugstore. Kill me, and I go home for the holiday, and it's gonna show, and people will see.
Whose is it?
I haven't been with anyone but you.
You said there was that boy in high school.
Yeah, that was high school.
I can't withdraw money, pay for an abortion.
I don't want an abortion.
You want the baby.
Look, I don't know.
I've been working for the last 15 years to set up the next 15 years.
This isn't about you, or your career, or your wife, or your kids, or your retirement. This is about me and my body. It's in my body. What do you want me to do?
Just don't stop coming to class.
Trent's taking me for wing night. Cheap bastard. Don't wait up. Have fun.
Thank you. woman's world is her husband, her family, her children, and her house. Who said this? Shall I give you a hint?
The same person who said a violently active, dominating, brutal youth
is what I'm after. Adolf Hitler. How do we compare these two statements? Miss Knowles, I'm so glad you could grace us with your presence today.
You told me last night not to miss class.
As we were saying, how could one man, any man, so embody evil? Was there something else?
Under the wide and starry sky, dig the grave and let me lie. Glad did I live and gladly die, and lay me down with a will.
Allison.
I won't miss.
What does she mean by that, do you think?
I don't know. She told me once she was interested in poetry.
And you have no idea why she'd want to kill herself?
No.
She was deranged. Who knows why these kids do anything?
Yeah, people who are troubled aren't without logic, Mr. Carson. Might seem illogical to the rest of us, but they're usually quite mindful of what they're doing.
Doctor. Dr. Carson.
And what are you doctor of?
Humanities.
Well, there you go. And the gun. Still missing. You don't know who might have picked it up?
No, it was all confusion.
Or why anybody would want to pick it up?
No. Jesus.
Well, I'll be checking records, talking to her friends. Nothing new under the sun. She either had trouble with drugs, with a grade, with a boy, with a girl. We'll find it.
Professor, I know that orals are coming up next week, but some of us would like to, you know, get a car, drive out to Allison's funeral, whenever that...
There will be class, Ryan. Tomorrow, the next day, the day after that, and all next week. So pass the word. Don't miss. Weaver.
I just saw it on the news. Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
I might take a nap here this afternoon. I have a lot of work to catch up on now.
You know her?
No, I barely knew her.
I love you.
I love you too.
It's late. Are you coming to bed?
I'll be up in a little while.
If you looked at your syllabi, You noticed we'll be covering the next 5 years of the Third Reich. Jung's feelings after the Second World War on science and technology included thoughts on whether man is related to something infinite or not. He insisted on the reality of evil, not external evil, but evil within the self. He said that de-Christianization was not only foretold as prophecy, but is an inevitable psychological law.
Apparently, they ran a test for drugs, didn't find anything, and then decided to check. No idea who the father is.
Are they gonna run a paternity test?
Against whom? And what would be the point? Yeah. I'm just worried about the goddamn gun.
She's a student.
I got it. Professor Weaver.
Hi, Professor. It's Lauren Mattis.
I was Allison Knoll's roommate.
Can you meet me here tomorrow morning? I think we need to talk.
Why are you showing me this?
It was hers. Thought you might like to have it.
Thank you.
Last year, I dated a guy from town. Kind of ran with the wrong crowd. He gave me this. His idea of a gift. Only Allison ever knew that I had this. But the police are asking everybody questions. They talked to me last night. It's only a matter of time before they come looking.
And you picked it up after she shot herself.
If I didn't have this, Allison might still be alive. If I try to hide this here on the hill...
It wasn't your fault.
I made a copy of her journal. It's in her handwriting, so sort of a keepsake. We were friends, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There will be a test tomorrow in essay form on man, the impersonal engine, the only animal that inflicts pain for its own sake, who originates nothing, not even a thought. Dismissed. Dismissed!
I won't miss.
Looks like we're missing a few people today.
We've been looking at history and the lives of men who have made it. For your essay, discuss in 3 pages, history versus autobiography. If history is hearsay filled with interpretation, is it truth?
And if every man has secrets he can't admit even to himself, is autobiography possible? You have 40 minutes. Begin.
You told me not to miss class, so I'll keep coming.
Forever.
Starry sky. Dig the grave and let me lie. Glad did I live and gladly die. And lay me down with a will.
Oh, that didn't work out very well, did it?
If you have an affair with an innocent girl and you dump her and leave her alone in the world, when she dies, you might just get rid of the lady, but you'll never get rid of the ghost of the baby.
I think all she wanted was a better grade. So much for higher education.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. It's enough to make a dead girl lust. Fasten your seatbelts. We're off again.
I don't want to leave you.
You have to go to work.
I'm scared. Every time I come home,
I'll be here forever, George.
Hey, Doc. Feeling all right?
Yeah. Is there anyone else in tonight?
Just Markham and North Wing.
Listen to this, George.
I don't hear anything.
Come with me. Look, George, can I trust you? Never mind. It's not a scientific question, is it? Do you know what that is?
A new sports drink?
Very funny. That's dust.
I got dust at all.
From Mars.
I'll be.
It's been through NASA, SETA, CDC, EPA, and probably CIA covert ops. The old man has us checking to confirm what everybody else already thinks they know. It's useless. I've hit it with radar, sonar, microwave. I've bombarded it with curium 242, X-rays, rock and roll radio.
Doc, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Watch this.
Containment field activated.
They did everything right. They just did it all backwards. I need you to get me access to the superconductors on main lab.
But you don't have clearance to that.
I know, but if I can complete the testing...
Why don't you just ask Annalena to let you in?
Annalena will take the credit. His facility, his contract, his discovery.
But... what... what does it do?
How's your wife?
Are you saying that...
I don't want to get your hopes up. It'll take years of R&D before we have anything conclusive. But I left it out next to a tray of leukemia cells we harvested. The next day, this stuff had created thermophilic lichens on the cells that reverse carcinogenic...
Audrey could be cured.
I'm not saying it will cure anyone within the next 5 or 10 years, but with the right amount of funding given to the right team, scientists that I know, not Annalena and his crew...
She could...
Maybe... someday, diseases like cancer will be cured. People won't have to suffer like what she's suffering now.
Could you test it? On her?
In its present state, it's raw. I have no idea of dosage or how to administer.
What's the worst thing that's gonna happen? She's been given 4 months.
If I give it to her now, it could do worse than kill her. It could... I don't know. There's a certain combustibility.
When would you need to get on the main lab?
I need to set some levels. I mean, say next week before they pull the project on me. Will you do it? George, someday, thanks to you.
Yeah.
All we need is time.
Time is the one thing she doesn't have. Thank you.
recovery?
I feel better. A lot better.
If I could meet you, you'd know how I take my coffee. If I could meet you, you'd put up with all my habits. I would see. I have to go to work. When I come home, we should talk.
Talk dirty?
Have you ever... Audrey? I'm sorry, I didn't know what else to do. I was only trying to help you.
You were very brave.
I could have killed you.
But you didn't. George. I need more.
Oh. What the hell?
It worked.
What? Last night. Audrey.
What?
Listen
what?
To me. The cancer. It's gone. She's better. Better than ever.
Oh my God.
You did it!
Look. We have no idea what the long-range effects of this...
Don't you understand? You cured her! She's better! You've done what nobody's been able to do. You can have anything you want. Money, fame, it's all yours.
If they find out I allowed the dust out of the lab...
It won't matter, not now, not after this! Look, if there's any trouble, let it be mine. I have Audrey again. I don't care.
No, and Alina will take the credit for everything.
No!
This is a federal contract. If they thought I tested it without sanction, I'd be ruined.
And if they know you took it, that I didn't have anything to do with
it. Doc! Alex!
Please.
I can't let you take this.
Please!
I'm sorry. I can't. A few more weeks if I can work it up to animal testing.
No! George, you are not taking any of that dust out of my lab! Alex! Alex!
Next funeral, I'll
I'll bury him on top of the new grave.
I don't know, sir. He was here last night, in the lab. But no, he was still here when I left.
If you get anything, call me.
Thank you.
you'll excuse me, I have to go clean up. It's getting awfully dusty in here. Well, what'd you expect, a happy ending? Until next time, I'll keep an eye out for you. Well, I hope you enjoyed the show. Stay scared.